times, at your home, office, and other places. It's the most natural thing. You all have the power in you. It's not that you don't know what I'm going to say. I am going to say what you already know. But then, there's a difference as to why I'm saying it here and now. How many of you are not married? Wonderful. So, whom do you all live with? Your parents, friends, how is it?
Parents.
Friends. Okay, you.
Friends.
In case you slept, not slept for a long time, and you're asleep somewhere early in the morning, and your friend switches on the light, how do you react?
Shout at the top of my voice.
Exactly. So he has the power of voice. It's not natural. Each one of us, and how many of you married? Yes. And first, let us ask the men. Okay. What happens when you leave a wet towel on the bed?
An addition to the checklist.
Yes. And when do you get very happy with your husband?
When I go home and I find a surprise waiting for me.
Yes. And how do you express that?
I just thank him. I'm happy.
How do you mean that?
I just say thank you so much for.
If it is a surprise, how do you say it?
I said, wow.
Exactly. She has the power of voice. So all of us do these things very naturally in our day-to-day lives. But then why do we need to know these nuances of the power of voice for a speech? That's because we are all alone here when giving a speech. We don't have anyone to interact with while giving our speech. And you have 25 to 30 pairs of eyes looking only at you. That makes you all the more conscious, scared, worried, and even tense so much that your mouth dries up, your tongue sticks to your palate, and you don't know what to do. So when you pay attention while preparing your speech to these nuances of the power of voice, you can mark them on your paper, on a printed sheet of paper, as to what to do, where, when, and how. And that is why you need to hear to this presentation of mine. Before that, I would like to just start off initially like this. For that, to be pleasant, not to be agitated. Don't fight with anyone when you come here for a speech. Have a pleasant frame of mind. Don't come in a rush. And all that is very important for you to keep your mind pleasant and be ready to speak. Natural. Everyone must be themselves. Only when you're yourself, you can speak well. You feel what you say. Otherwise, it becomes put on. I've seen a lot of youngsters, they want to speak well. I have done that. When we see someone who speaks very well, you want to emulate them. You want to learn the way they speak. You want to do exactly the same things, thinking that it will work for you. But I'm sorry to say, it won't. You can absorb a lot of their characteristics, no doubt, but make it your own, to your own personality, to your own style. And there are some who put on an accent. Oh yeah, good morning, how are you? Why do you need that style? Be yourself. But most importantly, when you do that, if there is somebody entering the room without an applause, not during an applause, you will shake it because it's not your style. You will have prepared it only for that particular speech. So it goes out of gear. So be natural, be yourself, and then being yourself in a sense, in India especially, we have various languages with their own influences, regional influences. Like a joke my brother-in-law told me, he lived in Calcutta, and somebody came home. This is not to put down anybody, it's just that we have to be clear in what we say naturally, but it should convey the right meaning, is what I mean to say. So he came and said, "So, please come to a wedding night." My brother-in-law said, "What? To a wedding night?" Then he understood what's the wedding night. So, Bengalis normally say wedding for wedding. So the meaning should be correct. You say with a little. So we have to pay attention to those. And there are some people who say bulk. For bulb. Yes? And pocket. Instead of pocket, you say packet. I have kept it in my packet. Then give me the packet, I said. Where can you get the packet? So it becomes, and there was a yoga class, and a friend of mine told me, and he was from the Northeast. See, it is okay if you are in a day-to-day transaction, you can understand. But then when you're giving a speech, especially, it has to be understood the way you have. So you have to pay attention to remove those little regional influences which might change the meaning. So this girl was doing her yoga and she had to push her knees tighter. So he said, "Puss, puss." She didn't understand, "Where is the cat? Where is the cat?" And for her to push her knee tighter. So these things of misunderstandings can happen. And how many of you know Kannada? Okay, just for you. My son once said, "Amma, chocolate look good." "What? You have chocolate look good." I said, "If you do this to the shopkeeper, he'll give you a chappli because the chocolate couldn't be heard as chocolate, but in a different manner." So we have to be natural, but stick to the correct meaning of what we are saying. Forceful. Forceful, according to me personally, means be convinced with what you are speaking. Convinced with your speech so that you can get it across to your audience. If you are not convinced of what you are speaking about, nobody else will believe you. There are inspirational speeches. There are so many different kinds of speeches which we have. And for that, we need to be forceful. I believe in it. I have to believe in it for you to understand that you can also believe in it. And that is the reason we come here to give our speeches, so that people believe in what I believe. I say there is no corporal punishment to be given to children. It is the worst thing that can be done. And if I'm not believing it, if I'm not forceful enough, they will not bother. I said, it's okay. Corporal punishment is not important. What does it mean? It's okay to beat the child. That meaning will be conveyed across if I say it that way, if I'm not forceful. Expression is very, very important. All of us do it day after day. Suppose you receive a call from your girlfriend. How will you speak on the phone? When you pick up the telephone, how will you say it? How will you say the hi? Expression of voice. You don't have to see the person. And many a time, I remember once my daughter was at Pune. She just left home for the first time. She was away from home for a long time. And she was missing home. And I said, hello. Hello. That's all she said. And both of us had tears in our eyes. She was missing home. And just that hello itself gives a lot of pain and impact to anybody who hears it. So that is how expressive you should be. There are different kinds of expressions. And I would like one of you first. Yes, where is it? Can I have one of your members? Yes, please. Come. Your name?
Yeah.
Toastmasters, I want to say hi, how are you, to a friend whom you have seen after a long time. Okay, I'm a friend who you're seeing after a long time. So how do you say?
Hi, how are you?
Okay, after 20 years you're seeing.
Who are you?
Who are you?
Okay, 10 years. Thank you. For me personally, yes. If I'm seeing a person, that's what I was trying to say, is each of us is different in personality. But for speech, you need to combine everyone's personality and get it out there as the best speech. I am very dramatic. Whereas there is a friend of mine who is not dramatic but conveys very well without being dramatic. I want to be like her, she wants to be like me. Next. So if I were to say, hi, how are you? Hi, how are you? That is my expression. There. Can I have another member of Electronic City? Anybody here? Who's next? Yes, come. Indresh. Yes. I want you to say the sentence angry. Don't you dare utter one more word. Very angry.
Don't you dare?
Attempt.
You can say, don't you dare do anything, you say whatever you wish to say.
No, actually, I'm a good person.
See, in the speech you may have a hotter day at a time.
Yeah.
Okay, just
don't have dare to do that thing.
Thank you very much. Yes. So, everything changes when it is angrily said. That is his expression of anger. Now, come. Yes. No, you're doing something. Next. Dee, go something. I love you, Raja. Stay home for some more time. It doesn't have to be a boyfriend. I love you. Stay for some more time. Some more time. Just stay together.
I love you. Please be here for some more time.
Why? Thank you. Yes, Toastmasters, she was? No, no. Yes, come. I don't want to go there. It's very dirty. You can say it whichever way you want. The disgust.
I don't want to go there.
It's disgusting. Okay.
It's disgusting.
Okay. One more.
I don't want to go there. It's disgusting.
Okay. Thank you. So, here for me personally, if he could have put in a little more effort, then you could say disgusting has to be out there in your voice. It's disgusting. I can't go there. You know, like we're going to step or cow down. How should we feel? So you think of that. So it's like that. So that is about expression, and I already mentioned about how it has to be easily heard, which is very, very important. And then we go on to the characteristics of good speaking voice. These are the basic necessities of being pleasant, forceful, all that. Volume. Volume is very important in any speech. mentioned earlier, it has to be her till the last person. But then, there are different kinds of falling. If you are happy, if you are excited, how is the volume? How is the volume? Can anybody tell me?
Hi.
Hi. Please come. Now, you are angry, and the volume, this is, oh God, why have you come here, is your sentence. Say it angrily, and check your volume as to how you are going to say it. It's a place where somebody shouldn't have come. So you are saying, oh God, why have you come here?
Oh God, why have you come here?
Exactly. Thank you very much. So this is the volume. Call for an auto now. Yes.
Yeah. Auto!
You think it will be heard? Auto! Very affectionately, you're calling. He's far. Then you're desperate for the auto. Then,
auto!
Okay. So you can get into the situation. So many times we have to really get into the character and the situation to be forceful of what we are saying. Then, so this way, volume differs from context and place. Go to the next slide, please. Pitch. Pitch is something is measured on a musical scale. All of us get confused a little between volume and pitch. Volume and pitch are different. Like, hello, hello, that's a volume difference. But the same thing, pitch is hi, hi, hi is a higher pitch. Hi is a lower pitch. For example, when a dog barks, how does it bark? I want you to do the barking of a dog.
In very high pitch.
No, you do the barking. I want you to bark like a dog. Just a bark. You can do sitting there, no problem. He's welcoming you and barking. Okay? That is the situation. So how will he bark? Normal barking of a dog. That's all I'm asking for. Anybody else? He seems a bit shy about it. I said normal barking. Just a normal barking.
Bow, 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 bow.
Exactly. Wonderful. Let's bow, bow, bow. And now, you step on the dog's tail without your knowledge. And how does it go?
Woo!
Wee, wee, wee! Oh, wee, wee, wee! It goes like that. That is a higher pitch. Bow, bow, bow is a lower pitch. To more understand better about the pitch, have you all heard of the song by Lata Mangeshkar? Aapke nazaron ne samjha. So she sings, aapke nazaron ne samjha. High pitch, I can't sing like that. Whereas, how does Usha Uttar sing? Rambha ho, 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 ho. So that is the lower pitch. So there's a pitch difference from each person to person. Today's observation for pitch was, I had Toastmaster Preetam and Toastmaster Seisha speaking. I would like both of you to come here and say a couple of sentences. And I want them to recognize who has a higher pitch. Please come. You can say whatever you want, a part of the speech which you said in the beginning.
Thank you all for being here today and helping us select the next set of office bearers.
The same sentence.
Thank you all for coming here today and select the next set of office bearers.
Now who has a higher pitch?
Seisha.
Seisha has a higher pitch and he has a lower pitch. So, thank you very much. So, pitch becomes different at different times. The same dog, if you step on his tail, will have a different pitch. Whereas, if he is normal, his pitch will be lower. And then, there is one pitch which most students hate. Which is that pitch?
That's the idiot of
it. By your parents, the pitch your parents use for you. The monotonous pitch. And when do they give it to you?
Exams.
exams and they are lecturing, you must do well. If you don't study now, you will never be able to pass and come up in your life. By that time, you are gone. So that is how, which varies from context to context. Then rate, this is very, very important. Everything is equally important, no doubt, but rate. Rate, normally by Toastmaster standard, is 125 to 160 words per minute. You don't have to sit and count as to how fast. So there has to be a moderating rate of words with which you can capture the audience's attention. I have heard in our club, in the beginning of when a few speakers used to come, especially the new speakers, there was one boy and he said, I am from this place. So it becomes so boring. There is so much gap in between, you don't even understand what is coming next. And there was another girl who used to go like a train. And she would want to finish her speech so fast that a 7 minute speech would be over in 4 minutes. So that was the kind of speech she had. So we had to keep telling her, cut down your rate, cut down your rate. And then she understood. And incidentally, she was an acting president one day and it came out so beautifully. Every word she said could be understood, felt emotionally by each one of us. So the change that Toastmasters brought in her was really, really wonderful. So that way, your rate of speaking is very, very important. If I can add a little anecdote to it, my father-in-law used to speak very fast. And it was Vaikuntha Ekadashi, a time of the year when everyone, including the non-temple goers, visit the temple. And I'm one of those non-temple goers. And I was at home with my son and we had this godrej lock. You know, the moment you pull it, it closes. And you need a key to open that. We had only two sets of keys, but one somebody else had taken. And my father-in-law said, shall I give you the key and go on going? And I couldn't hear and understand what he had actually said. I thought, shall I give you the key and go in? And very smartly, I closed the door. With my son, I went out to the temple too. And 2 hours, I spent happily chit-chatting with people here, there, everywhere. And I returned home to see a long queue on the staircase of our house because the door was locked. I couldn't understand what he had said. I thought he had taken the key. Instead, he had kept the key, which I hadn't understood. So later, the locksmith had to come and it was really five sparks between me and my father-in-law. But anyway, so that way, the rate of speaking must be such that there shouldn't be any miscommunication. Next, quality. Quality of a speaking voice has to be pleasant. It can't be jarring. We can train our voice with exercises, breathing exercises and vocal exercises to improve our voice quality. Some have very shrill voices, so it is very difficult for them to reach. So these things improve the quality of the voice. The more you use your voice and practice, the better it gets. Next, silence. Silence can be good. When you give a speech, pauses are very important because some pauses take advantage of the human train of thought. Like all human beings think alike. For example, I had been to Goa and my God, we had such a lovely time. We drank like nobody's business. We drank tender coconut. So what did everybody think? What did you all think?
Beer.
Yes, beer, whiskey, anything. The moment I drink means it comes. That is, and Goa and drink goes together. So everyone thinks like that. And in one particular movie, I don't know which movie, I think it's Kuch Kuch Kuch, I don't remember. I think Shah Rukh Khan goes and tells Kajol, I love your best friend. Something like that. So the impact of the pause can be shattering. You know, for a person who is feeling something for the other person, can be shattering. That is the kind of effect the pause has. Another anecdote, if I may share. My children and I were sitting and talking and we have an old aunt called Revati Auntie. And suddenly, I'd forgotten to tell them. And I said, you know what? And she's 85. And I said, you know what? Revati aunty. Immediately, they said, Daida. I just said, Revati aunty, and I paused. So 85, and she should be dead. That was the impact of the pause. Unfortunately, I said, broke her hip. So, these are the effects of pauses, and it gives a lot of impact and absorption to the audience. So, it makes a lot of difference. The pauses, the pregnant pauses can give a lot of impact. And sometimes feelings, you know, the very word, I miss my talk. So, for some, it's a very important part of their life. For some, it is funny because how can anybody miss a talk? So the impact of the pause is very, very important. Next. Like I already said, expressive. Your voices have to be expressive of the different kinds of emotions we face. Happiness, sadness, angry, naughty, mischief, anger, hatred. Any kind of expression has to come in through your speech. Don't hesitate. Feel your speech. Tell your feelings. And the entire speech is what you believe in. So be expressive. Don't shy away from expression. Last but not the least, rehearse. For this speech, even if I have given it for the 10th time or the 12th time, I rehearse before coming. Otherwise, we take things for granted. Oh, okay, I've given this presentation so many times. It's okay if I miss a few. I may not miss a few points, that is a different thing. But I will definitely miss if I have not rehearsed. Then I go back home and think, oh my God, I should have said that point. We have to rehearse, which is very, very important. Even I'm a theater actor, and we do so many rehearsals, even if it is the 20th show. We have to have those rehearsals because there can be a disturbance if there is a change of space, change of the co-actor, for example, or change of the voice, it goes haywire. So the rehearsal is very, very important. Like for example, if I'm doing a particular role and my co-actor is absent, the regular co-actor is absent, somebody will stand in proxy. But you won't get your lines with the same impact because the give and take between the actors is lost. Hence, either way, you have to rehearse, whether you have a co-actor or not. You have to stand here and allow time and space for the audience response. If they are laughing, you wait and then continue your speech. For all that, you need to rehearse your speech. If you will know, you will feel your own punchlines. And if you think they are going to be funny and the audience is going to laugh, you will learn to wait. Imagine the audience is laughing. Wait for a couple of seconds and then continue practicing your speech. So all that can be rehearsed. So that is how your power of voice can be used in a speech. Thank you.